good morning to all centers and online students welcoming today map orientation class. So here I am Praveen Chaube, who will teach you all the map series, important maps like India map and world map, what are the important things required for your prelims, mains and even interview exam. Okay, so what is the purpose of today's class? Let me explain in detail what is all about this map series. Every year you will see 5 to 6 questions that directly from map based. Okay, so first important thing I want to mention here, that why map is important for IAS exam. Okay, why this maps is important? Now first thing you should always keep in your mind, that this map basically is an intrinsic part of your UPSC preparation. It is not a separate thing, it is an intrinsic part. This is the very important part of your UPSC preparation, and this map means strategy to crack this examination, prelims examination. One very important process you should know very well, you have very well knowledge of what are the different things located in different part of the world. Okay, so first thing, that is it is an intrinsic part of your IAS preparation. Okay, this is not a separate thing. Okay, and second important thing, every year 5 to 6 questions directly from map. 5 to 6 questions basically means total 10 to 12 marks in GS paper 1, and this 10 to 12 marks is not means easy to get without knowing, without you have a very good information about the maps of different part of the world, even India. So 10 to 12 marks is important, because you know a single questions decide whether you will be qualifying prelims or not. So rather than to learning lot of facts from art and culture and different environment section, you should give your focus more on map working. Okay, and very easy if you know the strategy, how to read atlas, how to locate a place on any part of India, what are the important new places that are in news. If you are keeping all this point in your mind, then this is very easy for you to solve all the 4 to 5 questions that is given in your question paper. Okay, so what are the things required for your map based class? This is my request to all online student, whenever next time when you will be come in classroom or when you will attend this session, please keep atlas along with you and one separate notebook. Okay, that notebook only contain your map related work. Okay, whatever we will do in this classroom, I will tell you to write some important facts, you should write in a separate notebook. Now what are the important materials required for your map? Every student should have one atlas. Okay, one atlas, one is called your Oxford school atlas, and another one is called, I am writing or any one atlas, no need to purchase both atlas, any one, Orient, Black Swan, this one is called student atlas, Oxford student atlas, and this is called school atlas. Any one atlas, Oxford atlas or Orient Black Swan atlas, any one, no need to require purchase both the atlas. This is the first important source, or we can say materials source. Okay, and second important one is your daily newspaper. Okay, daily newspaper means every day you are reading the Hindu or Indian Express. Any one newspaper that is sufficient, any one atlas that is sufficient, no need to buy both the atlas, no need to read two newspaper a day. Okay, only one newspaper is sufficient. And try to locate important places that given in your newspaper. Suppose there a dispute is going on these days about Citizenship Amendment Act. Many places you will see a dispute is going on. Try to locate which place is located, where is this place in our India, which place is located in Uttar Pradesh. Okay, so this will help you to know, you will become more familiar with your Indian map. So daily newspaper and Oxford student atlas, one important thing. Second thing, or third thing I want to tell you, that previous year's question paper. This is very important to know, see the previous year's question paper, because when you will see previous year question paper, you have an idea what type of question basically map, basically that is belong to map based questions. Okay, so previous year question paper is very important. Every year you will see 5 to 6 questions, and under 5 to 6 questions 2-3 questions directly, and rest one indirectly question, but that required your map based knowledge. Okay, to solve particular question you required a very good strategy. You have a visualized picture in your map, in your mind, about the Indian map or world map. Okay, so this three important things you should always remember, that you should buy a one atlas and daily newspaper, whatever news you are reading. Okay, and I want to mention fourth important thing, 15 minutes every day atlas reading. Okay, 15 minutes every day. Try to give 15 minutes every day after the completion of your entire work, entire classroom study, class revision of all class notes, and before going to your bed, please see 15 minutes atlas. And every day you should make your strategy in such a manner that today, suppose you are seeing the India map, then tomorrow you see the India, suppose today you are seeing the India political map, tomorrow you will see India physical map, and then after tomorrow you will see a South Asia map. So every day you see a different part of the world. That will be help you to know the things in a very proper manner. Okay, at the same time, while reading a newspaper, you should always carry your atlas, because whenever you will read international news, suppose you are reading about the USA, something happening in USA, something happening in Saudi Arabia, so try to locate which sea is very close to UAE, which sea is very close to the Yemen, Oman. Okay, so that will help you to understand the location of a particular place. Okay, so this all four important thing, previous year question, I'm giving emphasis on previous year question paper. This is very important, because previous year question paper, this will help you to understand the questions, a pattern of question, what type of UPSC basically ask question, map based question. Okay, UPSC never will ask randomly any part of any questions. Okay, I will discuss what type of question basically UPSC ask. Now, basically two type of questions UPSC ask in prelims examination. Okay, two type of questions. Even you will see a past year question paper, you will see there are two type of question. One is a static based question. Static based question that every student, every IAS aspirants who are going to write prelims, you should know this thing, static based question. Okay, that is the part of your NCERT. Okay, from the question, maybe from NCERT. For example, there was a question in 2014. In 2014, there was a question, Turkey is located between. Now, this is the Turkey is located between. Yes, Navdeep, this video will be available. This is the video, is recorded video. This video will be available till the prelims, 31st May 2020. All this, those students who are not watching right now, this recorded lecture will be available till 31st May 2020. Recorded video will be available. You will be able to get access. Okay, and that will be uploaded in your portal. You will easily watch anytime. Okay, so this video will be available. Now, there was a question in 2014, Turkey is located between, and there are many options are given, Black Sea and Mediterranean Sea. So, this is a static question. Okay, this one is a static question. While reading a newspaper, newspaper, any location, suppose you are reading about the Saudi Arabia news, Persian Gulf news, you are reading about India, Iran news, relation between India and Iran. In that case, you will be able to see the location of Turkey. And Turkey is located between Black Sea and Mediterranean Sea. This is a factual static type of question. Okay. Second type of question basically UPSC asks, that is called dynamically based. Current based question. Okay, dynamically current based questions. Okay, for example, like consider the following pair. Consider the following pairs. Okay, consider the following pairs. Then they are given a cities, name of cities that was in news. Okay, name of the cities that was in news. And country, we have to locate the country. Then they are given the name of the cities and given name of the country. We have to answer which of the following pair is correctly matched. So this is entirely a current based question. It means this required a current knowledge, current information about what type of means news is basically related with the particular country, what type of issues is there. So two type of question is here. One is called a static based question. Same static based question means when we consider about India map, India political map, like in how many country, in how many states Himalaya mountain passes, from how many states Western Ghat passes. So these are called a static question. And when we talk about current affair based question, then maybe about this, some tribes are in news, some national park are in news, some important species of India that was in news. So maybe question will become, this is name of the species and particular state. Which state you will find this type of species. So such type of question will become under dynamically current based questions. So try to understand the pattern before starting your reading atlas. You should, your strategy should be, your first thing you should know, ki what type of UPSC generally ask question. And this will only information, this answer, or you will only get when you will see a past year question paper. So past year question paper is very important. Past year question paper is very important. Dynamically current based questions and static based questions. Okay, please try to note down all this bit information. Okay, now next important thing, structure of our map series classes. okay. How I will take your map series classes, what are the important thing first I want to explain. So when we talk about map, we will see a India map, another one is called world map. Okay, India map. So we'll start from India map, okay, map, and that India map will first complete political map of India, and then we'll start physical map. Okay, so political map and physical map, first you have to understand political map of India, you know, because of removal of Article 370, now Jammu and Kashmir not considered as a state, divided into two UTs, Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh become a two union territory of our country. So maybe in next year prelims there will be a question from a political map of India, okay, which of the following maybe the there will be a question about arrange the following UT according to their largest geographical area, which UT have largest geographical area. So that type of question, be prepared with such type of question in political map. And then physical map. So physical map, one of the very important, in physical map you will see important mountains of India, important rivers, entire physical features, that is the important soils of India, everything will be come under in physical map. Similarly, same structure for a world map. In world map we will see the important, some static portion will do. Static portion in the sense like all seven continents, like what are the important mountains in Asia, Africa, North America, South America, Australia, okay, Antarctica, important places that are means news, and some dynamic part. Dynamic part basically include your like a Persian Gulf. Okay, so like dynamic part include your first Persian Gulf, that is the favorite part of UPSC, always there will be one question from Persian Gulf. Okay, second important like South China Sea location. So we'll see all the important places that always in news, that become a part of news, will deal with each and every location. So political map of India, will start from the political map of India, and then we'll move from physical map of India. But political map of India will include each and everything, will deal with each and everything. What are the, we means expect the question that will become in next year, or possibility of the question that will become in next year, we will deal with all important places. So any question from online student you have regarding map, any query you have, online student Navdeep, Chetan, other online student, if you have any doubt till now, you just ask a question, because you know map is one type of dynamic part, it is very difficult to know from where you have to start, okay, from where you have to begin to start for map work. So this is important. Okay, so let's start political map of India. Political map of India, we'll start from today. Political map of India today, political map of India. And yes, Navdeep, current places will be covered. This is the part of our class. Okay,
current places will be covered in our class. I told you, our structure of lecture will be divided into two parts. One part we will deal with the static portion, that every student should know how many states Himalaya passes, what are the important seas of the world, like Black Sea, Caspian Sea, Mediterranean Sea. You will see every year there is a question. There is a question from this type of seas. Which of the following country make border with the Black Sea? Which countries make border with the Mediterranean Sea? So such type of questions static portion we will do. Beside, we will also do important news. Okay, what about the important news that you always see in your newspaper, and where location of particular places, important places, that possibility of question will be come in next year a prelims examination. Another question from Navdeep, besides atlas, is it necessary for us to make a mark place in map? Yes, this is a very good strategy, Bindu Madhavan. This is a very good strategy. You always keep a pencil along with your atlas. That is a colorful pencil, not that pencil, colorful pencil, and try to locate. Suppose you are reading political map of India. Okay, so if you find some important news, important places that always mention newspaper, try to mark by a red color, or try to mark by a green color. Okay, but when you will deal with the physical map of India, suppose you are want to locate the entire path of entire location of Ganga River. From Ganga River, start from Haridwar till the Bay of Bengal. So try to locate that river in your map, physical map, by a different colors. So this will help you to understand. This will be help you very easily memorize each and every place in a very short period of time. Okay. So you can do. This is a very good strategy if you want to, because seeing the place and without marking it, that will not make any sense. So try to locate a particular place by a different color of pencil. Any other question? So today's class will start with the political map of India. First of all, you all have a new political map of India that was recently released by Indian government, and that become a dispute between India and Nepal. In current affair, we had done one important topic, that is the Kalapani disputes between India and Nepal because of release of new map of India. So Kalapani location, that is given in your Uttarakhand place, that make a border with India and Nepal, that is disputed area between India and Nepal. So this Kalapani location given means that was in news recently. So maybe question will be come in next year prelims examination. Okay, so we'll do today a static portion, a part of political map of India. So let's see. So political map of India. So first you should know some factuals. So India is the 7th largest country of the world by area. This you should know, because maybe in prelims question will come about consider the following statement, and which of the following statement is correct. So this factual thing you should always keep in your mind. India is the 7th largest country of the world by area. India account for 2.4% of the total world surface area. Okay. Now the first important thing that we'll do in today's political map, we will see which of the following is the largest state of our country. So before seeing this, let's see a new map of our country, new map of India. That is, this is the new map. Okay, so you see very clearly mentioned here Jammu and Kashmir, not here mentioned about the state. This is Ladakh is a one UT, and Jammu and Kashmir is the another UT. So this is the new map of India. Everybody should download this map or buy latest app atlas from market, where you will see a new map is mentioned, and it, because this will help you to know a river passes through Ladakh and which river passes through Jammu and Kashmir. This is the part of your physical map, and that possibility of question will come in next year prelims examination, whether Indus river passes through Ladakh or Jammu and Kashmir both. Okay, so this is one of the important information for your next year prelims examination. So this is the new political map. This is called this map is called a political map, where you will see the name of the states are mentioned with their capitals. Okay. So at present we have a how many states? 28 states, na? 28 states and 9 UT. 9 UT. Okay. So this factual thing should always keep in your mind. This is a political map of India, and how to study this political map, try to see the different places. First you see from where, which state you belong. Suppose you are belong to Uttar Pradesh, try to see Uttar Pradesh, where Uttar Pradesh is mentioned. Uttar Pradesh make a border with the Nepal, Uttar Pradesh have an international border. Uttar Pradesh also is one state in India which make a largest state border, like Uttarakhand, Delhi, Haryana, Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, Bihar. So total number of 8 states. 8 states are there where Uttar Pradesh make a border. So maybe in prelims question will become which of the following statement is correct regarding Uttar Pradesh, or maybe which state in our country have largest, that sharing the largest state borders. Okay. So try to write all this factual in your notebook. Okay. The first thing you should write, largest state of India. So which is the largest state of India, right? Rajasthan, as you know, Rajasthan is the largest state, right? Rajasthan is the largest state, and Goa is the smallest state of India in terms of area. So this is the important information. Maybe in prelims the question will become about the consider the following statements. So Rajasthan is the largest and Goa is the smallest state of India in terms of area. Okay. So with area 342,239 square kilometer, okay, Rajasthan accounts 10.41% of total country's area. This is the important information. Size of Rajasthan is slightly greater than Congo, the country that is in Africa. Congo is a country that is in Africa continent. The Congo is the 64th largest country of the world. So you can imagine area of Rajasthan is equal to Congo, and Rajasthan is also considered as a, may be considered as a area by area, it is the 64th area of the world. So India's largest state Rajasthan is more than 92 times bigger than its smallest states Goa. Okay, now this two important information that is not mentioned in your NCERT book, I just this copied from government site. So one important thing I want to tell you about UPSC exam, you try to focus more on government sources. Okay, apart from NCERT, your second more trusty based source is the government sources, whatever like economic survey, India yearbook released every year. So try to focus and try to note down the important information given in your particular source. So India's largest state, that is Rajasthan, is more than 92 times bigger than its smallest state Goa. This is very important information. Rajasthan, now this is the about the chronological order. Rajasthan is followed by Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra. Madhya Pradesh is the largest than Maharashtra by narrow margin, 532 square kilometer. Uttar Pradesh is the fourth, and Jammu and Kashmir is the, now this Jammu and Kashmir is not considered as a state. So that is a part of your UT. So that will be not a correct statement. Uttar Pradesh is the fourth. Okay. So try to note down all this information in your notebook, because this will help you to understand important facts. Okay. So new map of India, to download new map of India, please if you have any doubt, question regarding any information, static portion, you just ask question here. Okay, without any hesitation. So we have 28 states and 9 UT. Okay, now this is the important information, largest UT. Now India has total 28 states and 9 union territories. Out of the 9 union territories in India, Delhi, Puducherry, formerly called Pondicherry, and Jammu and Kashmir have their own legislature. Again, this is important. So to remember a map of India, this is very important to remember the some factual points, some facts regarding the states and UT. If you know the facts of a state in UT, that will help you to visualize the India map clearly in your mind, and will help you to solve the question more quickly. Question over the, out of the 9 union territories, India, Delhi, Puducherry and Jammu and Kashmir have their own legislature. So previously there was a 2 UT where legislature was there, Delhi and Puducherry. Now we have a 3. Okay, sir, can you please teach? Okay, just focus here. In a very, this is the to draw a map in a very less time, how to draw a map of India. Okay, so one question from Gagan, how to draw a map of India. See, where you will require to draw a map of India or map of the world in mains answer writing, okay, in GS paper mains. So suppose you have to write a answer about the monsoon of our country. Suppose you have to write about monsoon in GS paper 1, okay, you have to explain about the origin theory of monsoon. So how you will locate? So first, this is most difficult part of to draw map of India is the southern India, that is the part of southern India. So start from the Gujarat coastal area, okay, and then draw from the Tamil Nadu, okay. Suppose you have to represent southern part of India in your GS paper 1. So try to locate, draw only a southern India. Okay, southern India. And this will help you because no need to draw entire map. Okay, no need to draw entire. Suppose you have to locate the places in southern part of India or in GS paper 1, then just draw a southern part from peninsular India. Just from the part of Gujarat till West Bengal border, that is the coastal area, entire coastal area. And suppose you have to represent northern India, this is the northern India where you will represent, where you will represent the part of Jammu and Kashmir, okay, part of Jammu and Kashmir, Nepal and northern part of India. This will help you to, suppose you have to represent as the northern part of India, and in that case you will draw and you have to locate the rivers. This is the Indus River, origin of Ganga River. Okay, this will just draw some part of India. So then wherever the required, you have to represent northern part of India, draw northern India. You have to represent southern part of India, draw southern India. Okay, suppose you have to draw a northeastern part. So northeastern part, because this required a practice, without practice not possible. Because of location, because northeastern states more in news, Assam NRC, because of the NRC, okay, Constitutional Amendment Act, okay, two time zones in our country. So always this northeastern state in news. If you have to write an answer about the northeastern states, if a demographic of the northeastern state, if you have to write a natural vegetation of northeastern states, in that case you have to draw a, just only you have to represent a northeastern state. Because if you are going to draw an entire map of India for any one answer, suppose you are drawing entire map of India and just you are locating the one place, or just you are locating the this one place, okay, so no need to, this all place will be captured your answer book, okay, occupy a extra space, no need to means giving so much space, because you have a limited space, and write an authentic answer. So for that you draw only a limited part. So how you will draw, how you will learn to draw a diagram? Just start from, try to connect, try to draw first different part of India. First try to draw the northern India, okay, then try to draw a southern India, and then try to draw a northeastern state. Northeastern state, because this will help you. Once you are master in all these things, then you draw an entire map of India. Okay. Or in a simple way, suppose we have to draw a world map. While dealing with oceanography, if question will come in ocean current, you have to represent entire current, ocean current of Pacific Ocean, Atlantic Ocean. So always draw a middle one. This one is called equator. 0 degree is called a equator. And then start from the North America. Sorry, this is the part of South America. And then North America, South America, this is the part of Malaysia, then okay. So just represent entire South America, North America, Africa, Gulf, okay, Persian Gulf, this is the part of India, then Malaysia, then this is the Asia and Russia part. This will take time to draw a map. No need to draw a clean map, no need to draw an entire perfect map. Just it will be location, you have to just locate the places, locate the ocean current. Because you all, maybe if you have already done with the oceanography, you know the different ocean current of the world. Then we have a Atlantic Ocean current, and then we have a Pacific Ocean current, and then here we have a Indian Ocean current. So suppose you have to represent entire Indian Ocean current. So no need to draw this part, because this part will occupy extra place. What you will do, just draw this part, okay, okay, and just this is the North Indian Ocean, this is the South Indian Ocean. Just draw them, whatever the ocean currents are present this part, only that much is requirement, okay. So in very less time, how you have to draw a diagram, draw a map in a very less time, in a very less time in examination, you have to just represent the only location where the question is about. Okay, suppose the question is about entire Gulf of Kutch, about the Gulf of Kambat in India. So just draw a map of Gujarat. No need to draw the entire southern India. Okay, that will be, examiner will be understand what you want to draw. If you are means drawing a diagram only, just a location, important location, and try to write, this is the Gujarat, this is the Gulf of Kutch, this is the Gulf of Kambat, okay, this is the important part where this dispute is happening these days, okay. And suppose you have to represent entire northeastern states, so just draw a northeastern states map. So to avoid consume lot of time, what you will do, just draw a simple location, what is the question, where from where the question is about. So try to draw like this, okay. And if you have to represent only South America, North America, just draw North America. Hello Gagan, is it clear Gagan, are you understood? Gagan? Let's see here. Largest UT, as I told you about the because of the bifurcation of Jammu and Kashmir, that states change No, Jammu is Kashmir is not a state. They consider divided to UT. One is called Ladakh, and other one is called Jammu and Kashmir. So this is again a possibility of question will come in next year prelims examination. What type? India has total of 28 states and 9 union territories. Out of the 9 union territory in India, Delhi, Puducherry, and Jammu Kashmir have their own legislature. Each union territory has a capital of its own or the main area of administration. Now, these are the list of all 9 union territories, Jammu and Kashmir, Ladakh, Delhi, Puducherry, Diu and Daman, okay, and then Dadra and Nagar Haveli, Chandigarh, Lakshadweep, Andaman and Nicobar Islands. So, when we talk about the areas wide, the Ladakh is the largest UT followed by Jammu and Kashmir, and then we have Andaman, Nicobar, Delhi, Puducherry, Dadra and Nagar Haveli, Chandigarh, Daman and Diu and Lakshadweep. Please note down this one. Ladakh is the largest UT followed by the Jammu and Kashmir. So when a question will be about the arrange the following UT according to their largest geographical area, so your answer will be you should always remember Ladakh is the largest UT, then it followed by Jammu and Kashmir, and next Andaman Nicobar, Delhi, Puducherry, Dadra and Nagar Haveli, Chandigarh, Daman and Diu and Lakshadweep. So this is the political map. Today in class we are dealing with the political map of India, and in the political map of India we are basically doing with the static portion. What type of question will become, possibility of the question will come in next year prelims examination. So try to see this location in your map also. Political, you should all have a political map along with you, and a political map of India, and try to see Ladakh is the largest UT followed by the Jammu and Kashmir. And then we have Andaman, Nicobar, Delhi, Puducherry, Dadra and Nagar Haveli, Chandigarh, Daman and Diu. Okay? Is it clear? Largest state is Rajasthan and smallest state is Goa. Ladakh is the largest UT. Now, next one is the landlocked states. Which of the following state is a landlocked state in India? So what is the basic meaning of landlocked states? Landlocked states are basically states that means not sharing international border, okay, that not sharing any coastal land surface, coastal land. So that is called landlocked states. So landlocked states that is not share with any international borders, okay, that is called a landlocked state. So in our country India we have some states that is considered as a landlocked states. Now see the list of these states. So how many landlocked states do not have any international boundaries? So all the yellow mark states that is mentioned here is a landlocked state. So try to see Haryana is a landlocked state. You see Haryana is not sharing any international border or any coastal area. So landlocked state Haryana, that is sharing with Punjab, okay, Rajasthan, India, Delhi, okay, Himachal Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh. So Haryana. Another one is called Madhya Pradesh. So you see the Madhya Pradesh is a state that is called landlocked state, and this landlocked state share the border, Madhya Pradesh share the border with Rajasthan, Gujarat, Maharashtra, Uttar Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, okay. Then Chhattisgarh. So Chhattisgarh is again a landlocked state, because you know what is the landlocked state? Landlocked state is a state which is not sharing any international border or coastal water. So Haryana is a landlocked state, Madhya Pradesh is a landlocked state, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand and Telangana is a landlocked state. So out of how many states are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 states in India that is a landlocked states. So try to see this map. Okay, so total number of 5 states are there that have landlocked states in our country. So maybe in prelims question will become about the landlocked, which of the following state is not a landlocked state in our India. So you may mean possibility of such type of question will come in prelims, because nobody know what type of UPSC will ask question. So these are some basic question, and where we have to visualize the map of India. Okay, visualize the map of India. So remember all the name of 5 states. If you remember the name of 5 states, nearest neighboring states, then you will able to learn lot of things from the political map of India. Suppose you are reading about Jharkhand. So Jharkhand is a landlocked state. So Jharkhand is making border with the like Bihar, West Bengal, Odisha, Chhattisgarh, okay, Uttar Pradesh. So similarly, Chhattisgarh is a state. See how many states are making border with Chhattisgarh. One, Odisha is one, Andhra Pradesh is two, Telangana is three, Maharashtra is four, Madhya Pradesh five, Uttar Pradesh six. Okay, total number six states are there that making border with the Chhattisgarh. Similarly, we have Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan one, Gujarat one, two, three, then Chhattisgarh four, five states that make border with the Madhya Pradesh. Okay. So different things located in different map of India that will help you to understand, visualize the map in more proper manner. Okay. So these are some landlocked states. So there is a list is mentioned here. There are five states in India that have landlocked states. One is Haryana, Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh, Madhya Pradesh and Telangana. Okay. Next one. Largest coastline states of India. Largest coastline states of India means what is the meaning of this? Those states have a largest coastline. So we know that when we draw a map of India.
Agreement of landlocked states according to area. Such question possible?
क्या दिखाइए question क्या है? One question from Navdeep. Arrangement of landlocked state according. Yes, such question possible, Navdeep. Possible. Okay. So what you will do? Be prepared with such type of question. Landlocked states, they make us some twist. Okay. Arrangement of chronological order about the landlocked states according to their geographical area. So obviously the question will become. We have to know the. By seeing this figure diagram, map of India, you know Madhya Pradesh, largest geographical area. Then we have a Chhattisgarh, second number, and then Jharkhand, Telangana, and then Haryana. Okay, so be prepared with such type of question. Okay, next one. So other one is the largest coastline states of India. Okay, largest coastline states of India. What is the coastline state? Coastline states basically those states that have a border with seas or Bay of Bengal, Arabian Sea or Bay of Bengal. So that's start from the which state has the longest coastline in India. Now see this map is entirely about the coastline states. Now this is the map of India where you will see all states that have a coastline means colored means a green color, and other one Gujarat that have largest coastline is different color. So see the from here India coastline start till this place. So Gujarat, Maharashtra, Karnataka, Goa, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Odisha and West Bengal, all these states share have a coastal. Okay, so among these, which of these state have largest coastline area? So see here, state Gujarat 1214.7 kilometers coastline length, and then Andhra Pradesh 974 kilometer. Okay, so out of the how many states are there? 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9, total 9 states are there that have a coastal land area that share their border sharing with the water, that is Arabian Sea and the Bay of Bengal. So we have out of 9, Gujarat have largest coastline areas. Okay, so there is a coastline India has 7516.6 kilometer along the Arabian Sea through Bay of Bengal. The coastline of India start from the Gulf of Kutch. This is the called Gulf of Kutch. Okay, this area is called Gulf of Kutch. Across the Gulf of Kambat, this one is called Gulf of Kambat. Remember, this one is called Gulf of Kutch, this location, and this one is called Gulf of Kambat. Then Konkan to Kannur and through Malabar along the Arabian Sea and goes along the Bay of Bengal through Coromandel Coast, Puducherry, Utkal to Sundarban in coastal East India. Now, an important thing you should know see, coastal, western coastal plain, this one is called western coastal plain and this one is called eastern coastal plain. So those states border that share their boundary with Arabian Sea, that will become a part of coastal, western coastal area, and that states which share the border with the Bay of Bengal, that is called, considered as a eastern coastal areas, eastern coastal India. Now in our country, we know Maharashtra coastal plain with a different name, Karnataka have different name, Tamil Nadu have a different name, Andhra Pradesh have different name, and Odisha have a different name. So this is again an important information you should keep in your mind. What is the name given to Maharashtra coastal plain? Okay, so there is separately I mention everything. See, the first one is called a Gujarat. Gujarat 1600 kilometer. So this one is the largest coastal line. Andhra Pradesh 974 kilometer. Tamil Nadu is called Coromandel Coast. Okay, Tamil Nadu is called Coromandel Coast. Maharashtra coastal land is called Konkan Coast. Okay, Kerala is called Malabar Coast. Then Odisha is called Utkal Plain. Karnataka is called Kannur Coast, Goa and West Bengal. So this is the chronological order, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, according to geographical areas. Okay, according to geographical area, which coast state have largest coastal India. So again we see this map, Gujarat 1600 kilometer, okay, and Maharashtra, this is called Goa, then Goa very small, then Karnataka, Kannur, Kerala, Malabar Coast, Tamil Nadu is called Coromandel Coast, this entire coastal is called Coromandel Coast, Andhra, and this Utkal Plain is called Odisha, Odisha Plain is called Utkal Plain. Okay, so then West Bengal, sometime it's also called your Sundarban. So this entire, you know, this location is called Sundarban Delta. So this is the coastal areas. So we remember all the places, all the states that have a coastal land area, and maximum area having Gujarat. Okay, so Puducherry, Utkal to Sundarban, in that is Sundarban given name to the West Bengal. Then this one is called Utkal, Odisha is Utkal, Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu is called Coromandel Coast, Kerala is called Malabar Coast, Karnataka is called Kannur Coast, and Maharashtra Konkan Coast, and then Gujarat we have a Gulf of Kambhat and Gulf of Kutch. So remember, this is the southern part of India that may have a sharing with the water body. Okay, so try to write all this information in your notebook. This will help you to revise while writing your prelims examination. Before writing your prelims exam, please revise this all information. Okay, if you will remember all this thing, then any type of question that will be part of political map, you will easily answer, because such large information, such a large map, such a different type of map of India, if you visualize it, you keep in your mind, then this will help you to answer any tricky questions. So Gujarat, Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, all this is also important to remember, these states have a coastal land. Okay, otherwise maybe question will become, which of the following state does not have a coastal land, and the list of maybe UPSC will give 8 to 9 states name, and among 8 to 9 states they can mention about some Jharkhand, Bihar also mention some landlocked states. So please read your question paper twice or thrice in such type of question. Whenever you will find such type of question, first thing you should always keep in mind, you have to first read question properly 3 to 4 times, and then you will choose your correct answer. Okay, because such type of question always tricky, maybe you will be stuck in such type of question and mark a wrong answer. So please avoid such type of mistakes. Okay, now another important information, state share international border. Now this one is very important, state share international border. This is the large information you should always keep in your mind. We have these states, that the states mark in pink color, that all states share international border, like we have a Gujarat, okay, then Rajasthan, then Punjab, then we have a Jammu and Kashmir, not a state, now we have a UT. So this is Jammu and Kashmir UT, and this one is Ladakh, okay, Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, okay, UP, Bihar, West Bengal, Meghalaya, Assam, Arunachal Pradesh, Nagaland, Manipur, Mizoram, Tripura. This all states that mark in green, a pink color, that have a international boundary. Okay, so this India map, we have a different map of India that have different location, different mark, that will help you to memorize map in a very proper manner. So state share international borders. So try to see this state first, try to see this map and note down the map, note down the name of the states that have a shared international border, the first thing, because maybe in prelims question will become which of the following state does not have international border. So first thing you should always keep, which of the following state have a international border. So Gujarat, start from the Gujarat, okay, and then Rajasthan, Punjab, then Jammu and Kashmir UT and Ladakh UT. Please focus here, it's not entire Jammu and Kashmir. Now question will come in next year prelims examination, then they will be mentioned about Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh UT, not a state, okay. So this is Jammu and Kashmir and this one is called your Ladakh UT. So this, there will be a two important UT that share an international border, okay. So Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand. One important interesting point here that previously we have only states that share international border, now we have a two UTs apart from states. Now count the number of states. Gujarat 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. 15 states are there that share international border and two UTs. Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh are two UT that share international border. Okay. So important thing you should, this is the important area from where question will be coming next year prelims. Now let's see the important facts here, mention some important facts, detail of state forming, try to write down all these points, details of the states forming international border with neighboring countries, okay. Now this is not updated one because you will see here Jammu and Kashmir entire state's name is given. So please always be clear about Jammu and Kashmir. So Indian states which share international border with Pakistan, okay. So try to see with your map, okay, Gujarat, Rajasthan, Punjab. Now Jammu and Kashmir is not a state, so Jammu and Kashmir is a UT and Ladakh, because some part of Ladakh, that is the POK, that is the part of your that sharing the border with the Pakistan. So you have to focus here, okay. So Indian state which share international border with Pakistan, Gujarat, Rajasthan, Punjab, Jammu and Kashmir UT and Ladakh UT, okay. So what, how many states will be there? Three states and two UT will be here. Three states and two UT. Three states plus two UT. Indian states with share international border with China. So again Jammu and Kashmir is mentioned here. So Jammu and Kashmir is now UT. Ladakh. Now while seeing this map, new map of India, we see now Jammu and Kashmir is not sharing international border with the China, only it share with the Pakistan, okay. So keep this point in your mind, this is a very confusing here. Jammu and Kashmir is now considered as a UT, only Ladakh UT share international border with China, not Jammu and Kashmir. So remember here, so cut the name of Jammu and Kashmir. Jammu and Kashmir, instead of Jammu and Kashmir, we write Ladakh is the only UT that share border with the China, okay. And rest will be a correct Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Sikkim, Arunachal Pradesh. So total number of four states and one UT. Four states and one UT. Are you getting my points, student? What I'm trying to say you, these things are important because I am sure about 80%. I am sure about question will be come in next year prelims about the UTs because of configuration was changed, because now Jammu and Kashmir not considered states, divided into UTs. So possibility of the question from this location is more next year prelims examination. So this is the way you have to remember the name of the some factual points. Okay, so in, let's see first statement. Indian states which share international border with Pakistan, Gujarat, Rajasthan, Punjab, Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh UT. So three state plus two UT here. Indian state which share international border with China, Jammu and Kashmir will be not the part, Jammu and Kashmir not sharing, Jammu and Kashmir UT is not sharing international border with China. Instead of Jammu and Kashmir, you write UT, that is called Ladakh. And then we have Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Sikkim, Arunachal Pradesh. Okay, so let's see here. So Ladakh, this entire Ladakh is sharing with the China, Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, okay, Sikkim state here, and then we have Arunachal Pradesh. So 1, 2, 3, 4 states and 1 UT. So 4 states plus 1 UT that is sharing international border with China. Similarly, Pakistan, how many states are there? Pakistans are there, like Gujarat, then Rajasthan, 1, 2, then Punjab, and then Jammu and Kashmir, and then Ladakh. Okay, so 2 UT, 1, 2, 3 states. So be remember all these things. Okay, now move to next point. Another one, Indian state which share international border with Nepal. So very easy, you know, remember Nepal se kon kon state aisa hai jo share karta hai border, like Uttarakhand 1, Uttar Pradesh 2, Bihar, okay, then this is the West Bengal, and then Sikkim. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, total number of 5 states. So India states which share international border with Nepal called Uttarakhand. Okay, Uttarakhand. These factual points, Uttarakhand, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, West Bengal, Sikkim, total number of 5 Indian states that share its border with Nepal. Okay, so this is very important. These details of the states are very important, and I want to tell you about this, focus on these first two points, that is the because of Jammu and Kashmir become a UT, and your Ladakh become a UT. So there are 2 changes are there. Does state sharing coastal border does not count as international border? See, well, when you will see a Bindu, your question is very good. International or coastal areas? Coastal areas, see, most of the coastal areas of our country that is sharing the international, not sharing the international border, that sharing the coastal water. Okay, Bindu, sharing the coastal water. So you have a concept, we have a concept of called territorial water. 12 nautical miles from the coastal area is that water is considered as a that is considered a national water. So that will be not a possible, because we have only a coastal areas, states that sharing the only coastal land, not sharing the international border. Okay. Navdeep will be get this PDF handout and shall be it. Whatever you comfortable, Navdeep, this will be a PDF. I will upload PDF on your portal. You will easily get this PDF. Okay. Or if possible to write down some important points, whatever I am saying, that like just mentioning twice that please note down Ladakh and Jammu and Kashmir now become a 2 UT. So try to note down whether Jammu and Kashmir sharing its international border with China or not, or Ladakh or Jammu and Kashmir both sharing with international border with China or not. So this type of confusion may be create in your mind. This is very good if you will write here, okay, in classroom or while watching this video. This will help you to focus on a particular location of our country. Okay, so Bindu, that will be coastal border. This not count as an international border. Okay, another important information. ठीक है Now, focus on next point. India states which share international border with Bhutan. Bhutan ke saath kon kon sa ho jayega? Sikkim ho jayega, West Bengal ho jayega, Assam ho jayega, Arunachal Pradesh ho jayega. 4 states share border with Bhutan. Okay.
Another one, Indian states which share international border with Bangladesh. Which of the following states share the border with the Bangladesh? Now, because of NRC and CAA Amendment Act, Citizenship Amendment Act, this is again important news or important place. You should mark it. Now we have West Bengal, Assam, Meghalaya, Tripura, and Mizoram. Five Indian states share border with Bangladesh. Next one, Indian states which share international border with Myanmar, Arunachal Pradesh, Nagaland, Manipur, Mizoram. Four Indian states. So if possible, write down it. Indian state which shares international border with Bangladesh, Bhutan, and Myanmar and Nepal. Four country. Total number of six country we have. Now, so by this data we can say that the country which share its border with maximum number of Indian state is tie between China, Nepal, Bangladesh, each of which share border of with five Indian states. Okay. In other words, the country which touches the maximum number of Indian states are China, Nepal, Bangladesh, each touching five Indian states. So this factual is important and that will be considered as a map based questions. Okay. So to answer this question in prelims examination, because you have to answer within 2 hours and you have 100 questions in front of you, and in that we have to also visualize the picture, visualize the map of India in a very quick manner, in a very authentic and accurate manner. You should know the entire map. You should always keep entire map in your mind. That will be help you to answer this question. Now another one, Indian state with maximum international borders, three countries. The maximum number of international borders shared by Indian state is three. Okay. In other words, there are only maximum three neighboring countries of some particular Indian states. These states are Sikkim, West Bengal, and Arunachal Pradesh. Okay. So there are three states which share a maximum international borders. For example, Sikkim. When we see the map of Sikkim, that Sikkim sharing total number of states, total number of international border is 6. Sikkim share Bhutan, one international, Nepal, and China. Okay, so 1, 2, 3. Sikkim is the state in our country that share its state border, that is state border considered as international border with three countries. One is called China, Nepal, and Bhutan. Similarly, we have Arunachal Pradesh. So Arunachal Pradesh sharing border with China. Okay, then here is Bhutan, and another one, see that this is the part, this part is called Myanmar. Okay, so this is the Myanmar country, that is separate country. So Arunachal Pradesh sharing also sharing three countries, and is a state border that is considered as international border with three countries. One is called China, Bhutan, and Myanmar. Okay, similarly we have another one is a country that is called what next, West Bengal, that is the Bangladesh only. So this is again important information. Like West Bengal share international boundary Bangladesh in east, Nepal in the north, and Bhutan in the northeast. And we have Arunachal Pradesh share international boundary with Myanmar in east, China in north, and Bhutan in west. Okay, so all this three important information. Note, if India claim Gilgit-Baltistan, this is the part of POK, is taken to account, the state of Jammu and Kashmir also share the border with three countries. Okay, China in north, that is Pakistan, Afghanistan. This is a controversial issue, so UPSC will not ask this question. Okay, but since in reality the actual
Yes, Amit Kumar, with China only four states and one is UT, that is Ladakh state. Sumita Devnath, you have a query about that is the territorial water that is called 12 nautical miles, that is the part of, that water is the part of India, okay, that is the part of India, that water is the part of India. And then we have a contiguous zone that is called 24 nautical miles from the coastal area, that is also the part of India. And then we have an exclusive economic zone that is 200 nautical miles from the coastal areas, EEZ, exclusive economic zone. And beyond that is a international water. Beyond exclusive economic zone, that is 200 nautical miles from the coastal area of countries considered as a international water. Okay, so no, it's not sharing international border with Sri Lanka. Okay, it's not sharing with international border with Sri Lanka. Tamil Nadu have their own territorial water. India have their own territorial water. Okay. So beyond exclusive economic zone, that is called 200 nautical miles, beyond that is called international water. That is called international water. No country have their right, but only India have a right to extract some minerals from the seabed. So India have only a country in all over the world where it's get a international right to access beyond exclusive economic zone water. Okay. So Amit Kumar, with China only four states share with boundary, one is UT. So let's see in map, one UT, that is the part of your Ladakh, is the only UT that share the border. Himachal Pradesh, 1, 2, 3, 4, four states and one UT. Okay, Amit Kumar, four states and one UT, that is called Ladakh. Now, Indian state with maximum international border, two countries. So this is again important, you should know which of the following state that have maximum international border. So there are four Indian states which share international boundary with two countries. In other words, there are four Indian states which has two neighboring countries. These states east to west are Mizoram and Assam in northeast, Uttarakhand and Jammu and Kashmir in north. Whenever you will see the Jammu and Kashmir, please focus in a particular point. Okay, Jammu and Kashmir is not a state, now it's divided into UTs. So be careful with there. Mizoram share international border with Bangladesh and Myanmar, while Assam touches Bangladesh and Bhutan. Uttarakhand share its border with Nepal and China, while Jammu and Kashmir share its border with China and Pakistan. So basic idea here is that we have three states in our country and two UT, three states in our country and two UT that share a two countries international border. For example, Mizoram and Assam in northeast, okay, Uttarakhand and Jammu and Kashmir in north. Mizoram share international border with Bangladesh also and Myanmar. Okay, so this factual is 100% correct. While Assam touches Bangladesh and Bhutan, this is also correct. Uttarakhand share border with Nepal and China, this is also correct. So all three are correct. While Jammu and Kashmir share its border with China and Pakistan. So while seeing this Jammu and Kashmir, you should always keep in your mind, Jammu and Kashmir is now UT. Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh both share its border with Pakistan. But in case of China, only Ladakh one UT. Only Ladakh is one UT that share its border with China. Okay. So this is the important thing. Okay, Jammu and Kashmir is now divided into UTs. So Indian states with maximum international borders, two countries. Okay, there are four Indian states. Now there will be no four Indian states. There will be three Indian states plus two UTs are there. Okay, two UTs are there that share international border. Let's move to next one. Indian states which are neighboring to only one country. Only one country. Not because we had already seen three country, two country, one country. Only one country.
So there are 10 states which share their international border with only one country. These states from east to west are Nagaland. Okay, you know Nagaland share with the Nagaland share its border with the Myanmar, Manipur, Tripura, Meghalaya. Manipur and Manipur share its border with the Myanmar. Tripura it share border with the Bangladesh. Meghalaya again it share its border with the Bangladesh. Bihar again share its border with the Nepal. Uttar Pradesh again it share its border with the international border with the Nepal. Himachal Pradesh, okay, this is again a Nepal. Punjab again Pakistan. Rajasthan Pakistan and Gujarat Pakistan. So this is again important information. Indian states which are neighbors to only one country. One country. So as you see, three different type of questions. States having neighbor to three country, two country and one country. So there are 10 states in India which have their international border with only one country. These states from east to west. So be prepared. Maybe question will become, arrange the following state from east to west or west to east. So Nagaland, this is share its border with the Myanmar. Manipur, Myanmar. Tripura share with the Bangladesh. Meghalaya, Bangladesh. Bihar, then Nepal. Uttar Pradesh, Nepal. Himachal Pradesh, Nepal. Punjab, Pakistan. Rajasthan, Pakistan and Gujarat, Pakistan. So this is the only one country. These states are that sharing an international border with only one country. Now again important factual point here. Country that shares longest border. The length of the shared border in decreasing order with different neighboring countries of India are as follows. So it's already mentioned about decreasing order. So length of India and Bangladesh border order is 4096 kilometer. So Bangladesh, okay, that is the share largest international border with India, that is 4096 kilometer. Okay, length of India China border is 4057 kilometer. Length of border shared between India and Pakistan is 3,323 kilometer, including line of control in Jammu and Kashmir and international border. So you know there is a line of control that separate Jammu and Kashmir state with the POK, Pakistan occupied Kashmir. So we are also counting that line of control length and some international plus international states border like Punjab, Gujarat, Rajasthan. That in total include 3,323 kilometer. Length of India and Nepal 1,751 kilometer. Length of India and Myanmar 1,643 kilometer. Length of India Bhutan 699 kilometer. Length of border shared between India and Afghanistan 106 kilometer. As per India's claim, the shared border with Afghanistan lies Gilgit-Baltistan, which is Pakistan's control. So when the question will come about the, because of this Ladakh creation, now we have a Ladakh that share its border, Ladakh UT that share its border with the Afghanistan. Okay, so this is the factual point you should always keep in your mind, or try to note down, because this PDF will be, I will upload this PDF, no need to worry, and this will help you to write down all the important information. Okay, now another one. State shares border with Ladakh UT, because of UT created a new one. So which of the following states that share border with the important UT that newly created? The one is called Himachal Pradesh and Jammu and Kashmir UT. Okay, two state, one state and one UT. So that share the border with Ladakh, Himachal Pradesh and Jammu and Kashmir. Again, this one is important factual. Other important information, Tropic of Cancer passes through how many states? Okay, so this is a very old question, and because UPSC not directly asked till date, so be prepared with the next year question. Maybe Tropic of Cancer passes through how many states? So this is the map of India where you will see the Tropic of Cancer passes through. This is the Tropic of Cancer. This Tropic of Cancer passes through first one Gujarat. Okay, second one Rajasthan, third one Madhya Pradesh, fourth Chhattisgarh, fifth Jharkhand, sixth West Bengal, then Tripura, and then we have a Mizoram. So total number of 8 states. Okay, from
total number of 8 states through which tropic of Cancer passes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So, Gujarat, Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, West Bengal, then Tripura and Mizoram. Now, out of this total 8 states, how many states share international border? Maybe in question, it will come in prelims in new different manner. Those total number of 8 states are sharing through which tropic of Cancer passes. And out of 8, how many states have international border? So we have a Gujarat have international border, that is with Pakistan. Okay. Then we have a West Bengal, another one West Bengal, and then Tripura and Mizoram. So total number of 4 states. Out of 8 states, we have a 4 states that have international borders, or plus they through which tropic of Cancer also passes. So tropic of Cancer, 23.5 degrees northern hemisphere, and tropic of Capricorn in southern hemisphere is called 23.5 degrees southern hemisphere. So total number of 8 states through which tropic of Cancer passes. Now with the help of this map, you will able to know, try to locate the capital city of each states. Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, West Bengal and Tripura and Mizoram. Okay, this is your homework. You will try to locate the which is the nearest capital city. Which is the nearest capital city that is very close to the tropic of Cancer. So I will, because you know Ranchi is the capital city of Jharkhand, that is lie entirely on tropic of Cancer. So Ranchi is the place in Jharkhand that is very nearest to the tropic of Cancer out of the 8 states capital city. Okay. So this is the name given: Gujarat, Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, West Bengal, Tripura and Mizoram, the 8 states that through which tropic of Cancer passes. Now another important thing, Indian standard time passes through how many states? This is the very important, you know, Indian standard time, that is called 82 degrees 30 minutes east longitude, passes through Uttar Pradesh. Okay, so Indian standard time, you know what is standard time? We all country, which we all the citizen of our country follow the same time, that is called Indian standard time. Okay, this is the 82 degrees 30 minutes east longitude. East longitude. I hope all you have completed your basic part of geography, where you will read about the eastern. Why this we mention here? East longitude. What is west longitude? 82 degrees 30 minutes east longitude. Okay, and from where it measures time, we have a concept of prime meridian. Okay. We have a concept of prime meridian, that is the one meridian that is passes through Greenwich, London. So suppose this is the map of this is the globe, and we have a prime meridian that is called 0 degree longitude. Okay, 0 degree longitude. Now this is the our IST. So our IST passes through, and this is called 0 degree equator, and we have a our India is present in northern hemisphere. So this is the location where India is present. So this is the Indian standard time that is passes through a 82 degrees 30 minutes east longitude, and 0 degree, this is called prime meridian, and we call this 82 degrees 30 minutes is the 5 hours 30 minutes ahead of GMT. This is GMT basically mean Greenwich mean time, or we can all we call as also as a world time. So standard meridian of India, which is passes through Uttar Pradesh, the place somewhere you will see a Mirzapur is mentioned, somewhere you see Allahabad. So try to locate Mirzapur is the place from where 82 degrees 30 minutes east longitude is passes. And important information here you should keep, how many states, from how many states this IST passes. So this is the map of and again the map of India, where you will see IST. IST, this is the 82.5 degrees east longitude. So it passes through Uttar Pradesh. You see Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Jharkhand, Odisha. Okay, Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, not Jharkhand. This is the Chhattisgarh, Odisha, and Andhra Pradesh. Okay, so and this line, this one is called 90 degree east longitude. This is the proposed. As you know, there is a dispute between between northeastern states and in the rest of India, because they are demanding a two time zones concept, they demand either two time zone concept, or they want to increase our IST by half an hour, means the instead of 82.5 degree, it must be shifted from 82.5 degree to 90 degree east longitude. So this one is disputed one, this one is disputed line. So UPSC will never ask you 90 degree east longitude, it only ask you IST, because that one is more authentic and correct. In our country, we all the places in our country, like whether it's northeastern states or this western states, we have a same time and we are following the 82.5 degree Indian standard time. And this IST passes through Uttar Pradesh, okay, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Odisha and Andhra Pradesh. So states touching maximum state borders, okay, so try to locate these places in your map also, okay. Another one, state touching maximum state borders, state touching maximum state borders. So like we have a UP, UP is the state in our country that share maximum state border, then we have a Assam. So these are some important factual point about the political map of India. Rest thing we will do like important cities, important places, important capital cities. Like previous year there was a question, about which of the following place are very close. Suppose there is a, this is the longitude, this is, you know, you have a concept, this one is called horizontal, one is called latitude, and this vertical line on the globe, this vertical line on the globe is called a longitudes. So there was a question in 2014 about suppose Delhi is located this longitude, which other places is very close to the same longitude. So for example, in India, if you draw the map of India, so if this longitude is passes through a particular place and Delhi is located here, which place other cities are very close to this longitude? So such type of question I will try to make similar question that possibility will come in next year, okay, about the longitude or latitude, IST, this is the Indian standard time, which of the following important cities that very close to IST. Another question, Tropic of Cancer passes through India. Tropic of Cancer passes through India. Which of the following city is very close to Tropic of Cancer? So such type of question, I will make some conceptual based question, then I will give you to solve in classroom. Okay. Now we'll move to the physical map of India. Any query, any questions you have? If you have any doubt, political map of India, then just raise your question here. Okay. Then we'll start a physical map of India. So political map of India and physical map of India, both are important. In political map of India, we know there is mentioning about the name of the states along with their capital. Now we have a physical map of India. In physical map of India, basically we locate mountains, plateau, plain, rivers, soils, vegetation and different things. Okay, this is the physical map of India. And physical map of India, you see mentioning about the very clear picture about this is the triangle shape, indicate name of the mountains, okay, it's not visible clearly here. This is the physical map, Himalaya is mentioning here, then Aravalli mountain range, then Thar desert. Okay, you see very clearly there name of the some rivers, Ganga river, Ghaggar river, Kosi river, Brahmaputra river, okay. So physical map of India required a different strategy. First we have to know the location of mountains, okay, and location of rivers, from where the river originate and it passes through which of the following states, and then important mountains of India like Himalaya mountain, Aravalli mountain, Vindhya mountain range, Satpura mountain range, okay, Then in southern we have a Western Ghat, Eastern Ghat, Nilgiri Mountain. So name of the different mountains are mentioning here. So the first thing I want to mention here, that Himalaya Mountain. Okay, the Indian Himalaya region is spreading on 9 states, because there was a question in 2015 out of how many states Indian Himalaya Mountain passes. So Indian Himalaya passes through 9 states, administrative region, and 2 UTs, namely Jammu and Kashmir, Ladakh. Okay, so total number of 9 states and 2 UTs. One is called Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh, 2 UTs, as you know, Himachal Pradesh, Uttaranchal, that is Uttarakhand, Sikkim, Arunachal Pradesh, Meghalaya, Nagaland, Manipur, Mizoram, Tripura, and hill regions of 2 states called Assam and West Bengal of Indian Republic. So basically, Indian Himalaya region, when we talk about Indian Himalaya region include all, we have a Great Himalaya, okay, then we have a Middle Himalaya, that is called a Lesser Himalaya, okay, and then we have a Shivalik. The 3 mountain ranges, you know, these 3 mountain ranges, okay, these 3 mountain ranges. And when you see the map of India, you will see a Purvanchal, that is Eastern Himalaya, okay, this is the part of Himalaya. So this is the location, we have a Great Himalaya, then we have a Lesser Himalaya, then we have a Shivalik, and this is called a Purvanchal, called Eastern Himalaya. So this entire thing is called a Indian Himalaya regions. Now this Indian Himalaya region, it passes through total 9 states and 1 UT. So we have a Ladakh, Jammu and Kashmir, because both will be places where Himalaya is present. And then we have Uttarakhand, okay, Himachal Pradesh, then Sikkim, Arunachal Pradesh, then northeastern states like from Arunachal Pradesh, Nagaland, Manipur, Mizoram, Tripura, okay, and then to Assam and West Bengal of Indian Republic. So these are the 9 states and 2 UT through which Himalaya region is passes. So there was a question, so in prelims, about this information you should know, okay, from where Himalaya, Indian Himalaya is passes. Okay, another one. So this is the Indian Himalaya states, very clearly mentioned here. Now we have 2 UT. One is called Ladakh, another one is called Jammu and Kashmir. So Jammu and Kashmir will be cut here and will write a 2 UTs. Okay, one is called Jammu and Kashmir, another one is called Ladakh. Then we have a Himachal Pradesh, Uttaranchal, Sikkim, West Bengal. See, the, all the states that have in region of Indian Himalaya states mentioning here have different colors. Okay, then 2 UTs are here. Then we have a Himachal Pradesh, this one is called Uttarakhand. Okay, then Sikkim, this is Arunachal Pradesh, okay, some part of Assam is here, then this is called Nagaland, Manipur, okay, Mizoram, Tripura, then Meghalaya, okay, then part of Assam. So these are the some Indian Himalayan states: Sikkim, West Bengal hills, Meghalaya, Assam hills, Tripura, Mizoram, Manipur, Nagaland, Arunachal Pradesh. So total number 9 states. Another question: Aravalli passes through how many states? Aravalli is a old fold mountain. Himalaya is a young fold mountain. We'll discuss in geography class about the old fold mountain. What is the meaning of old fold mountain? What is the meaning of young fold mountain? So because of Aravalli was in news these days, Supreme Court passes one order that stop illegal mining in Aravalli mountain regions. So that's why we'll this is important for you should know the about the from where, which states were that part of Aravalli mountains. So northern end of Aravalli range is stretched of isolated and rocky hills and ridges that starts in Haryana and ends in, means Haryana is the one state, and we have a Delhi. The southwestern range of Aravalli passes through the Gujarat and Rajasthan. So remember the name of 4 states, one UT, Gujarat, Rajasthan, Haryana, and one UT called Delhi. Ajmer in Rajasthan is located on the southern slope of the Aravallis. This is again an important location. Ajmer, that is a famous place in Rajasthan that is located on the southern slope of the Aravalli. Situated near the narrow gorge, the city Bundi in Rajasthan is surrounded by the Aravalli range on its 3 sides. Okay, Aravalli are some of the oldest fold mountain in the world. Beginning from the Rajasthan in West India, the mountain extends to Delhi. The peak of Aravalli range are not pointed as young fold mountain. They have been eroded by the forces of nature like rain, wind and sunshine. So this is the old fold mountain. This is the sign of old fold mountain, that not a conical peak. Like when you will visit Himalaya, you will see a conical peak. Like this is the conical peak of Himalaya. But when you will see the Aravalli range, this is the like, this is narrow, dome shaped. Okay, so this is eroded, this conical part is eroded because of natures like some agents that eroded, rain, wind and sunshine. These are eroded. So that's why Aravalli is called a old fold mountain. Okay, and location of Aravalli basically present Gujarat, Rajasthan, Haryana and Delhi. Now, another important, Western Ghat passes through how many states? This is the part of physical map. Again, this was a question in 2015, how many states from where Western Ghat passes. So, you know Western Ghat, what is Western Ghat? When we draw a map of India, so this is the location, this is the mountain is present here, this is called Western Ghat, and then we have a, this is called Eastern Ghat. So this location, this is called Eastern Ghat and this one is called Western Ghat. Now there was a question, from how many states Western Ghat passes. So this is the one map, separate map for Western Ghat. So see here, states, the one state called Gujarat, because you know Tapi river is passes through here, Tapi river, south of Tapi river Western Ghat started. Gujarat, then we one UT called Dadra and Nagar Haveli, then we have Maharashtra, okay, then Goa, Karnataka, Kerala and Tamil Nadu. So this, from these states we have a Western Ghat. From Western Ghat, you know, many rivers are originated, like Godavari, Krishna, Kaveri river, Mahanadi river. Mahanadi river is originated in Chhattisgarh. Yes, Navdeep, Assam and West Bengal come under Himalaya states, because he mentioned Assam and West Bengal, that come under Himalayan state. That diagram not represent, but when we talk about Indian Himalaya regions, Indian Himalaya regions, that Assam and West Bengal will come, but only in a Himalayan state, okay, only in Himalayan state, then Assam and West Bengal will not come, okay. West Bengal and Assam will be not come under Himalayan state, because the Himalaya mountain not passes through a particular location. Himalaya mountain become more and more narrower in eastern part. Western part you will see there is a gap between Great Himalaya, Lesser Himalaya and Shivalik. But this gap become more and more narrower while moving towards Arunachal Pradesh. So Assam and West Bengal will not come under Himalayan states. Okay, when we talk about Indian Himalaya region, that is the part of that will become, but Himalaya separately, when we talk about Himalayan states, then Assam and West Bengal will not come. Okay, so try to focus here, Western Ghat. Okay, so Western Ghat passes through how many states here? Gujarat is 1, Maharashtra 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, total number of 6 states and 1 UT, 6 states and 1 UT through which Western Ghat passes. So Gujarat is 1 state, 2, Goa 3, Karnataka 4, Kerala 5, Tamil Nadu 6, total number of 6 states and 1 UT from where Western Ghat passes. Now you know Western Ghat is a very important physical feature of our country, physiography of our country. And Western Ghat, when you will see the map of Western Ghat, we have two different type of forests are there. Western slope of the Western Ghat have a tropical evergreen forest. And then this part of Western Ghat that is facing toward the Arabian Sea, we'll see like a tropical evergreen forest, and the slope, opposite slope that is facing toward the Karnataka state, Maharashtra state, they have a tropical deciduous forest. So we have a two different type of forest in different slope of the mountain. So we will cover each and every topic in detail. Okay, Western Ghat will come in next class lecture also, and where we will be mentioned about this type of soils are mentioned, what type of national park, biosphere reserve, different tribes. Okay, when we will deal with the these things, you will be more clear about a type of mountains, a type of different feature of Western Ghat. Now there was a question about the Western Ghat, but there is no question about Eastern Ghat. So be prepared for the Eastern Ghat for next year prelims examination. So Eastern Ghat, you know, a difference between Western Ghat and Eastern Ghat is very clear. Eastern Ghat is not a continuous as compared to the Western Ghat. Eastern Ghat is separated by a gap between the Eastern Ghat because a river passes from this. So we have states from where Eastern Ghat passes: Odisha, Telangana, Andhra Pradesh. Okay, try to note down the name of the states through which Eastern Ghat pass: Odisha, Telangana, Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu. So these are the states through which Eastern Ghat passes. So there was a question about the Western Ghat previous year there, still we have no any question from Eastern Ghat. So possibility of the question in next year prelims will come from Eastern Ghat, or maybe they create some different type of question. Eastern Ghat, which of the following states not a part of Eastern Ghat? Okay, so remember Odisha, Telangana, Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu is the part of your Eastern Ghat. Yes, Western Ghat passes through Tamil Nadu. See this map again, see this map. Tamil Nadu, you know, why Tamil Nadu? Because Vishal, Nilgiri, you know, Nilgiri is a mountain that is the connecting point of Western Ghat and Eastern Ghat. Nilgiri is the connecting point of Western Ghat and Eastern Ghat. So that's why Tamil Nadu is the part of where the Western Ghat is passes. Okay. So we have a Tamil Nadu, Kerala, Karnataka, Maharashtra, okay, and Gujarat and Goa, and one is UT called Dadra and Nagar Haveli. Okay, Vishal, clear? Western Ghat passes through a Tamil Nadu. Similarly, we have a Eastern Ghat. Eastern Ghat passes through Odisha, Telangana, Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu. Now, we have a difference, one chart where you will see the difference between Western Ghat and Eastern Ghat. See, Western Ghat and Eastern Ghat. Jara, okay. So Western Ghat stretches from Tapi River to Kanyakumari. Okay. Try to note down the difference between Eastern Ghat and Western Ghat. Maybe question will come. Consider the following statements, or consider the following differences between Eastern Ghat and Western Ghat, and you have to choose the correct answer. Okay. So Western Ghat stretches from Tapi River to Kanyakumari, and you know Tapi River is the west flowing river. Along with Tapi River, we have a Narmada River, that is a west flowing river, that is exceptional river. Okay, there was a question in prelims about the Tapi and Narmada rivers. Why Tapi and Narmada river is exceptional river, despite originate originate from the central part of India. Its Bay of Bengal is very close, very near. Why they travel longer distance and drain into Arabian Sea? So their answer is Tapi and Narmada river both are flow through a rift valley. Okay, what is rift valley? I will explain. Rift valley is a one geomorphic process where a rift valley created. So Tapi and Narmada river flow through a rift valley. Okay, but the Eastern Ghat stretches from Mahanadi Valley to the Nilgiri Hills in the south. So this is the Nilgiri Hills. I am talking about this Nilgiri Hills is the connecting point of Western Ghat and Eastern Ghat. Average width 50 to 80 km. Average width is 100 to 200 km. Most of the peninsular river have their origin in Western Ghat, like, you know, Godavari, Krishna, Kaveri river. Many west Godavari river is considered as Dakshin Ganga. So this river originated from the Western Ghat. No major river originate in the Eastern Ghat. This is important difference. Western Ghat continuous and can be crossed through a passes only. Eastern Ghat comprise the discontinuous and low hills. We'll explain the why this is the difference. Average elevation 900 to 1600 km. Average elevation about 600 meter. Okay. Highest peak is Anaimudi, that is 2695 meter. And highest peak of Eastern Ghat is Jindagad, that is present Andhra Pradesh, 1690 meter. Western Ghat receive orographic type of rainfall. Southwest monsoon coming from the Arabian Sea and causes heavy rainfall. That's why I am talking about Western Ghat. Suppose this is the Western Ghat and this is called a western slope, and this side of the Western Ghat have a evergreen forest and this side have a tropical deciduous forest. So you know what is the meaning of orographic type of rainfalls? The rainfalls that happening because of the relief, because of the presence of mountains in the path of rain bearing winds. So that is called orographic winds, orographic type of rainfall. When we talk about Eastern Ghat, almost parallel to the monsoon coming from Bay of Bengal and does not cause much rainfall. So be clear here, a big focus here, that Western Ghat only receive orographic rainfall. This is not happening with the Eastern Ghat, because in Eastern Ghat Bay of Bengal branch is more parallel. Okay, now we have a different name of the Western Ghat locally. It is called Sahyadri in Maharashtra, Nilgiri Hills in Karnataka and Tamil Nadu, Anai Malai Hills in Kardamom and Kardamom Hills in Kerala. So this is the different name. Maybe question will become in next year claims about the name of the Western Ghat. Consider the following pairs, Sahyadri name given and which states mein kis kya naam se kaha jata hai. So Maharashtra, Nilgiri Hills in Karnataka and Tamil Nadu, Anai Malai Hills in Kardamom Hills. Similarly, Eastern Ghat also known by a different name, Malia and Modugula Konda ranges in Odisha, Nalla Malai and Palconda ranges in Andhra Pradesh. Southward they are present as detached low hills, Javdi, Shivrai, Panchmalai, Shirumali and Varshu Nad hills. So this was the question in 2012 prelims about the arrange the following mountains from north to south. Arrange the following hills from north to south, and there is a mentioning about this, some of the name of the Nalla Malai, Javdi, Shivrai, Panchmalai hills. So main focus of physical geography, physical map of India, you should know chronological order from north to south, east to west. I will frame a questions in such a manner that will be help you to remember these things also, because in prelims maybe question will become about arrange the following mountain from north to south, from south to north, or east to west, west to east, or different cities of the India. So we will do, that's all for today. We'll also in our next class with a different map of India, where we will do a national park, biosphere reserve, wildlife sanctuaries, different tribes of India, different rivers, different important rivers of India, important seas of India, which of the following is a salt water sea, which is fresh water lake, different lakes of India and other important location. Okay, so if you have any doubt in today's class, just ask a question. We have a 5 minutes in hand, so if you have any doubt, Sumita, Amit, Navdeep, Vishal, this is today just orientation class. In next class we'll do more in depth about, we'll study the different part of India with current affair news. We'll also complete current affair news in next class. So quickly you just ask question if you have any doubt. Vishal, Navdeep, Sumita, Amit, other students. So buy one atlas, that is oriented Black Swan Atlas or Oxford Student Atlas. What you will do today, you just download previous year question paper from UPSC website, okay, and try to note down only map based question. What are the map based question already UPSC had asked? Rahul, yes Rahul, ask question. So very important to see previous year question paper, previous year question paper, and try to note down only map based questions. What are the map based question? And you know every year, yes Abhishek Patil, this video and a PDF file will be uploaded today, no problem. Yes, yes Rahul, there was a one question in UPSC prelims about if you travel by road in India from Kohima to Kottayam, that is the Nagaland to Kerala, then how many states you will travel? So for such type of question, you know, you have a very good knowledge of Indian political map. Okay, see, only those students will solve this such type of question. Those who know very well about location of the states, exactly location of the states. So for that you have to see regular Indian political map. Okay, so that required only road. Clearly mentioned there in question, there only road. If you travel by road from Kottayam to from Kohima to Kottayam, then minimum number of state you passes through in India. So such type of questions you should know the only one place from. If you are traveling from northeastern states towards southern India, then you have to go then Nagaland, then Assam, then West Bengal, then we have to move southward Odisha, and then Andhra Pradesh, and then Tamil Nadu, then Kerala. So there are different routes are there. I have one. This is the mentioning here. Yes. See here. One question was there: if you travel by road from Kohima to Kottayam, what is the minimum number of state within India through which you can travel, including the origin and destination? Okay, so option was there 6, 7, 8, 9. So see, this is the map, Kohima. So from Kohima to Kottayam, see, from Kohima, that is the part of your Nagaland. From Kohima, then you have to go Assam, because this is not possible, clearly mentioned about within India. So this is no chance to cross Bangladesh. You have to go first Chicken Neck. This corridor is called Chicken Neck. That is the part of that connecting between northeastern state and rest of India. So Kohima, Nagaland, Assam, then you have to enter this part, West Bengal, then Bihar, West Bengal, then Odisha, then Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, and then Kerala. So minimum number of states kitna hoga, need to cross Nagaland, that is the origin, this including the origin and the destination. So origin Assam, Nagaland is origin, Assam, West Bengal, Odisha, Andhra Pradesh, and then through either Tamil Nadu to Kerala, or through Andhra Pradesh to Karnataka to Kerala. So either way you will see a minimum seven states we have to cross. So for such type of question, what is the requirement? This is the requirement, that you should know the map of India. You have visualized the map of India in your mind and try to locate the place. Such type of question will solve in last, after solving all the questions, because it will take time to visualize. You have to confusion regarding one or two states, because each and every question, you can't do a mistake in a prelims examination, can't deliberately choose a wrong answer. So if you don't confident about whether this one is correct or not, please leave that question. Okay, don't choose the wrong answer, because one negative mark will means stop you to qualify prelims examination, or this will stop you to write a mains examination. So it is very important to visualize the entire map of India in your mind. So what is the next question? How to tackle question like how many states when go from one place to one place B? Okay, Rahul. So try to remember the map of India. One question from Tejesh: what basis IST is decided? See, Tejesh, Indian Standard Time, basically it is called a standard time concept. Okay, before standard time there was a concept of local time, when every place decide their local time on the basis of apparent movement of the sun. This, when the sun reaches the highest inclination at 12 noon, that is considered as a local time. But standard time is basically decided where important cities are, that longitude, that meridian, that is passes through a important city of the country. Okay, so this is the means one way how that will be decide Indian Standard Time, and it should be a multiple of 7.5 degrees. That is the from prime meridian. That is the different method. One question from Vishal: Oxford offer atlas, especially from Indian competitive exam, should we buy that? Yes, you can buy any one. No need to buy two atlas. You can buy whether Oxford or Orient Black Swan, any one atlas. No need to buy two. If you are not taking geography as an optional subject and you are for GS purpose, you just buy only one atlas. If you have a geography optional, then you have to buy two atlas, two or three atlas. There is a requirement of three atlas in geography optionals. TTK atlas, one TTK atlas, one Oxford atlas, another one is Orient Black Swan atlas. There is a requirement of three atlas for geography optionals. If you have no geography optionals, just buy only one atlas. Ready? Okay. So we'll see you next class. Okay. Come with your atlas along with the notebook. Okay. Thank you to all.